The Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1769, number general format. I love this job. This is the greatest thing in the world because I get to discover stuff along with you. The question came in at YouTube. Someone wants to do autofill, and they want to have it fill section 1, 1.1, 1.2, all the way down, and then start over at 2, 2.1, 2.2. I said, boy, wouldn't it be nice if the fill would just work, right? Yeah, but no way. It's not going to do that. Too bad. But we can fill these numbers here. Give it the pattern 1, 1.1, and copy down, and they will correctly get everything in. We just need to get then the section. Well, hey, that's no hassle at all. We're going to take this set of numbers here. We're going to do Control 1. We'll go to Custom, and we will put in quotes, whatever the text is, section space, and then 0.0, click OK, and we're done. No, we're not, because for section 1, we don't want the 1.0. I don't want that 0 to show up there. Ah, darn. Control 1, custom, in quotes, section, space, 0 point, pound sign, or hash sign, or number sign, depending on what country you're in, click OK. All right, almost there. Now we don't get the zero, but we are getting the 1 point. How annoying is that? All right, let's try the question mark. Control 1, custom, in quotes, section, space, end quote, 0 point, question mark. Question mark says, hey, only put the zero there if it's needed, and if it's not needed, go ahead and leave the space as if there was a number there, that way everything lines up, but I'm still getting the decimal points. Oh no, how horrible is that? And then I started to think about, am I going to have to use conditional formatting, set up a rule that says, if the mod of this cell, comma, 1 is equal to 0, then use one number format, otherwise use the default number format. And before I went crazy and did all of that, I said, let's just try this crazy idea. Click right here before general, section, in quotes, space, quote, and leave the general there. This is not documented. If you go to Excel Help, there's no way they say that this is going to work. But just in a fit of not wanting to have to do the conditional formatting, I tried it. Click OK. Check that out. You're actually allowed to use the word general in your custom number format, and it will do what general does with the decimal point. If it needs it, no decimal point. If it doesn't need it, there you go. Being able to fill. It's kind of a two-step process. Put in the 1 and the 1.1, fill down, and then use this custom number format here, and you are good to go. Well, yeah, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.